right, if the class will please pass forward your homework assignments. And, Mr. Richardson, why haven't you done yours?
Well, that is pretty darn presumptuous of you, wouldn't you say, Mr. Williams?
I don't think so. I've given out 42 homework assignments, and you've handed in 9. Vegas oddsmakers are going with me.
Well, I have you know I don't do my homework because every time I hand something in, you give it back to me with some funky rotten grade on it.
I don't give you those funky rotten grades. Those are the funky rotten grades your work has earned.
Well, I've been working for you all year long, and I demand a raise.
Oh, you want a raise, huh? Why don't you earn some extra credit?
This conversation is just taking a very ugly turn.
Hi there, fight fans. And welcome to the 8th period main event between Ted the Enforcer Williams and Malcolm Richardson, the D-minus kid. These two have met before, but Mr. Williams remains undefeated. Some say it's his training, some say it's his ring savvy. But I think it's because he's the teacher. And here's the bell for round one. Let's watch.
I don't want to do any extra credit aside.
Ooh, and the kid lands a quick jab to the chin. He's smiling, he's confident. This could go all evening. This could go the distance.
No extra credit? You fail.
It's over! That quick, ladies and gentlemen, the kid has been knocked senseless. He doesn't know what class he's in.
But I wouldn't mind doing it if I had some help. Right, Doug?
Wait a minute. He's trying to drag the announcer in the ring. We'll be right back after these messages. Go to commercial. Go to commercial.
I think Malcolm is calling out for help, and we must pay attention to his plaintive cry.
But you don't want to give me any extra credit. I'm a bad extra credit risk.
Well, why don't we have a look at your homework, Doug?
My homework? When you say my homework, do you mean the homework with my name on the top of the page? Because I did it. But in an absent-minded moment, I seem to remember the writing Reggie Coltrane on the top of the page.
What?
Uh-huh. Well, apparently we have a proprietary discrepancy as to whose B-plus this is. Whose is it?
Mine! Uh-huh.
Well, since you all seem to have one voice, maybe you'd like to do this extra credit assignment together.
Hey, how come I have to be lumped in with these two?
Because, Mr. Coltrane, what would Moe and Larry be without Curly?
I resent that. This is unfair. I want to be Moe.
Mr. Williams, I don't understand why I need to do economics homework anyway. I mean, how is this going to help me in my life?
How is this going to help me in my life? Number one of the charts, ladies and gentlemen, followed closely by I Don't Need School and The Dog Ate My Homework. Well, Mr. Richardson, maybe economics will help you in your life, maybe it won't. Here's how we'll see. I want the three of you, as your extra credit assignment, to form a business.
Question.
The floor recognizes Shemp.
What kind of business?
Any kind of business you can prove on paper as economically sound. Something you believe will help you with your lives. Now, I want this on my desk Monday morning. And I know the three of you will see that this is a more productive weekend than playing basketball or making out in the back of the theater with your girlfriends.
Brain damage. Brain damage to the punch-drunk old teacher. Boxing should be outlawed, ladies and gentlemen.
To the hitman business. How much you pay me to kill Malcolm?
Well, I'll give you $5 up front and $5 when you bring me his head.
I don't think this is what the teacher had in mind.
Sure it is. I'm making a profit and I'm enjoying my work.
All right, look, I messed up, but I've already got this figured out. Law of supply and demand. What do we not have in Harlem?
Tanning booths. Country Western Music Hall of Fame.
A sushi bar.
What?
Tomorrow we go down to the Harlem River. We catch some fish, we clean some fish, we cut them up into tiny bite-sized little pieces, and we are in business.
So how are we supposed to catch these Harlem River fish?
With a magnet. We'll call our restaurant Sushi That Glows in the Dark.
We gotta come up with a serious plan.
Well, a successful business does give the people what they want.
So all we gotta do is figure out what the people want.
Think I'm getting an idea.
Marie, I've looked everywhere and I cannot find a single t-shirt.
I just bought you some new ones the other day.
Well, they're not in the drawer.
Sharon, she's at that stage where she's wearing everybody's clothes but her own. Sharon, have you been in your father's t-shirt drawer?
Please, I'm eating here.
Sharon, I don't mind if you want to wear my clothes because they're currently fashionable, but you have to tell me the truth.
The truth is, if I took your t-shirts and I didn't tell you, I should be punished.
You should?
Yes, I should be beaten within an inch of my life. Hi, Doug. Well, my work here is done.
Doug, what is that under your arm?
Hair, Ma. Your little boy's a man now.
What you doing with my t-shirts, man?
I'm just using these t-shirts for a school project, Dad. See, me, Malcolm, and Reggie are supposed to dream up our own business and write a report about how we do in the job market, but we're going to do better than that, see? We're going to actually start our own t-shirt company and show the teacher that we're A-plus material.
My favorite word in that whole long nothing was job.
Oh, no, not the job thing again. Ma, can you get him off this?
I'm just going to put these t-shirts back in your father's drawer.
Dad, this is not a job conversation. This is a school conversation. Now, you got to stop talking about job when I'm talking about school.
Get a job.
You're on a continuous loop, man. And besides, school is my job.
One doesn't eliminate the other.
I'm talking about my future here, Dad.
I'm talking about your future out of here.
Hey, I look for a job. It's a bad job market.
Well, get a job at the market. There's a sign in the window, they're looking for a new box boy.
Oh, box boy. I remember when I was a little kid looking up at that slack-jawed idiot dropping the canned goods on the tomatoes. And I used to say, when I grow up, I want to be just like him.
Douglas, I started as a box boy. Now I have my own cab and supporting a family of four.
Dad, I got big plans for myself. I want to be something special. I don't want to be a box boy or a cab driver.
I see.
I don't mean to say that being a cab driver is a bad thing. I just mean it's a regular thing. I was outside and everybody was wearing the same t-shirt. So I figure if I come up with a catchy t-shirt, everybody will buy one and I'll be on my way to my first million.
Ah, so you're going to be the next... Who was the last famous t-shirt salesman?
Come on, Dad, you can't dampen my enthusiasm. Look, fathers are supposed to want their children to be better than them, right? Get with the program, Dad.
Marie, I've changed my mind. I'll let Douglas have my t-shirts.
Really?
Yeah. He's building an empire, and he's starting in my t-shirt drawer.
Real nice t-shirts for sale. Real nice t-shirts. You two can look like this professional model for only $19.95. Harlem Sushi. Harlem Sushi. Get it? Harlem Sushi? Only $12.95. You better buy them while it lasts. Only $7.95. Come on, let's go out there and let's buy American. Let's buy Harlem. Buy.
Lightweights. You know, you guys are going to give street hustling a bad name.
Oh, so I suppose you can do better, Frank.
My brother, you have obviously not read my upcoming book. I scam, therefore I am.
So what you saying? You think you can sell t-shirts better than we can?
No, I'm not saying that, because that goes without saying. I'm a professional. This is what I do.
Well, maybe you could help us.
Maybe I could. And maybe you guys could use a partner.
How much?
Well, 10% of everything I help you sell. Fair enough.
Now, how do we know you're worth 10%?
Give me the merchandise. What you mean by Harlem sushi?
I don't know, it just sounded funny.
Uh-huh. All right, my brothers and my sisters, Harlem Sushi, the new blockbuster motion picture starring Eddie Murphy and Pat Morita. Now, you see, it's about this brother from Lenox Avenue gets lost on the D train, winds up in Yokohama. Now, when these shirts are gone, they are gone until the movie comes out, and everyone will have one except you. Don't touch the shirt.
How much?
Well, now, that's a good part. Now, you see, those suckers in Beverly Hills are paying $30 a pop. But if you show me your ID proving you a brother of Japanese, I'll give you the unsigned version for $20. Or the limited edition, which is signed by Pat and Eddie, for $25. Pat and Eddie, Pat and Eddie.
Hey, Dad, how'd you do today?
$42 in tips. Not bad for a 10-hour shift, huh?
Wanna know how I did?
Don't give it another thought, son. The economy is bad and that box boy job is still open.
Yeah? You think a box boy can make $60 in 2 hours?
Whoa. Where did you get that kind of money, Douglas?
Dad, we sold all the T-shirts. We're a success. Dad. Look at this money. Aren't you proud of me?
You made $60?
People were just throwing the money at me, Dad.
You did better than me today, son.
So you aren't going to be on me about getting that box boy job anymore.
Douglas, I'm glad to see that you did something successful. And who am I to argue with success?
Wanted me to settle for that.
Adults have no vision.
Yeah, we don't need any vision to see that the mother load has unloaded on us.
That's right. All you gotta do is put the right guys with the right business.
Yeah, we've been in the wrong business since kindergarten.
What business is that?
School.
What?
Why do we go to school?
Women.
To get an education.
Why?
Women.
To get better jobs.
Why?
To get better women.
To make good money.
What's this?
Good money.
So, why don't we just cut out the middleman?
Hey, you talking about school?
Why do we need to go to school?
Because that's where the women are. Wasn't that your point?
My point is that I've had to listen to my teachers make me feel small and stupid since I was small and stupid.
Hey, Mom, we just got a little lucky. We're not gonna quit school over this.
This isn't luck. And I'm not wasting my peak productive years sitting in some classroom.
I'm not with you on this one, Malcolm.
Doug? Fine. I'll just consider our partnership officially dissolved. Even without school, I know enough math to tell me a one-way split is better than a three-way split.
Hey, Malcolm, you sure you know what you're doing?
Hey, I always know what I'm doing. Hey, lighten up, guys. We'll still be friends. I'm just gonna be the rich one.
I don't know about you, but I couldn't sleep a wink this weekend in anticipation of our extra credit report on the state of the entrepreneurial jungle. So it is my pleasure to turn the floor over to Mr. St. Martin, Mr. Coltrane, and all right, where is he?
He isn't here.
But I bet you he shows up.
Yeah, me too.
Well, I can't wait until he gets here because I live for Malcolm's excuses. You remember the time he spent the day in Central Park when he found out that only he could prevent forest fires? Boy, I love that Malcolm, you know? I love him. Where is he?
Hi, Mr. Williams.
Hey, Malcolm, Malcolm. Come on, come on, come on. What happened? What happened, huh?
Dropping out of school, Ted.
Come on, you can do better than that. And did you just call me Ted?
Yes, I did, Ted. because I feel very warmly towards you. You see, it was you and a year of you constantly embarrassing me that has pushed me out of this educational nest and has given me inspiration to find my own way in the world.
Oh, this is your report?
No. My letter of resignation.
Malcolm, you don't want to do this.
Oh, don't worry, Mr. Williams, I'll be back. Because you're going to be asking me to address the assembly on career day.
How are you?
Fine. How are you?
Fine. How's the plant?
Did you come in here for something?
No. I just wanted to see how you were and how the plant was, and if you're disappointed you married a cab driver.
James, you have never disappointed me.
But you know, it occurred to me that I'm always going to be a cab driver. I mean, which is not a bad thing, but it's a thing that I'll always be.
You want to help me hang this plant?
Douglas thinks of himself as a big-time businessman. And whatever dreams he has, I want to help him reach them. And when he does, I hope he isn't disappointed his father was just a cab driver.
James, whatever you are, first you're his father. And he'll always know that you fed him and pointed him toward the light, stood back, watched him grow.
You're assuming Douglas is as smart as the plant.
The women in the kitchen and the man returns from the workaday world. This is just like Little House on the Prairie. Except we let the mule in the house.
Do you realize how insulting that is?
You're right, Mom. I apologize to all the mules of the world.
Mom was talking about your women in the kitchen remark, you ignorant sexist pig.
And a talking mule, too.
Doug, do you know what I forgot to tell you?
What?
You're feeling pretty proud of yourself now that you and Malcolm and Reggie are going into business together, huh?
Well, me and Reggie. Malcolm turned out to be a corporate deadweight.
What happened?
Well, Malcolm wanted to quit school and go for the big bucks and work full time, and me and Reggie decided to stay in school. I will accept your accolades now.
Malcolm dropped out of school?
Yeah, we tried to talk him out of it, but he's making money, so what can we say?
Yes, but making money and keeping money are two different things.
Well, nobody keeps it. The whole point is to spend it. Look at this fly new CD player I bought.
Well, it's nice that you can do that, Doug. I know your father wishes he could buy all the things he wants.
Well, why can't he do that?
Because if he did, you would be hungry, naked, and out on the street.
Huh?
Doug, we're very proud of you. Proud that you've been able to put some money in your pocket. But the only reason you can keep it there is because your father uses his to put this food on the table. And it never stops, Doug. Because no matter how many times we feed you, you keep coming back for more.
Hi, get your t-shirts. Harlem Teriyaki is really a movie. Hi, get your t-shirts. Harlem Teriyaki. It's really a movie. How do you do that?
We haven't sold a single t-shirt all afternoon.
Hey, guys. How's business? Oh, this? My profits for yesterday. Of course, I had to stay up all night painting. It's a good thing I'm not in school. I don't see how you guys do it.
You're not exactly doing it.
Y'all gotta hand it to you, Malcolm. I thought it was luck, but you really pulled it off, man.
Thanks. At the rate I'm going, Mr. Williams is gonna be taking my economics class. Well, later, guys. Time is money, and I'm moving on to a better time zone.
Looks like me and you won't be making any more money in the t-shirt business. How am I gonna afford new CDs for my new player?
If I wanna make any extra money, I have to go back to helping out at my dad's dry cleaners. Why don't you help out your dad?
He's a cab driver. He doesn't need anybody to put plastic bags over the passengers.
My brothers and my sisters, aren't you tired of being ripped off by big business?
Yeah.
Anytime us little guys stuck together, huh?
Yeah, let's hear it for the little guys.
Now, the original manufacturer of this t-shirt has been gouging the public to the tune of 20 bucks a pop. But I am not your profit-hungry big businessman. I am like you, a poor, struggling brother trying to make it in a money-hungry society. It's me. It's you. We got to stick together. No, don't touch your shirt. Now, that is why I am giving away these t-shirts for $5 a piece. That's right.
Malcolm's going to kill you for stealing his t-shirt design, Franklin.
Malcolm is a businessman. He's mature enough to understand the rules of the competitive marketplace, okay?
You stole my design. I'm going to kill you.
Malcolm, my brother. Have you registered this design with the Federal T-Shirt Commission?
Hmm? You're underselling me. I can't sell this shirt for $5 and make a profit.
Well, now, that's what they call survival of the cheapest, right?
But you're gonna put me out of business.
Malcolm, now you know how people say, it's a jungle out there? Welcome to out there. Who wants a T-shirt?
Hey, Dad. Good day today?
I'm afraid to tell you. How many hundreds did you make?
Well, I worked 3 hours after school and I made $18.
T-shirt business must be in a recession. You could make that much money being a box boy.
Yeah. I know.
What's this?
I took the box boy job at Oscar's.
What happened to the T-shirt business?
Well, Malcolm's got that market cornered.
I think your friend Malcolm made a big mistake by quitting school, Douglas.
Yeah, well, he's taking a chance, Dad. Maybe his dream will come true.
Sorry yours didn't work out. But you got a lot of dreams left in you.
Yeah, and I know they're gonna come true too, Dad. But until they do, I'm gonna settle for a real paycheck.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Because paychecks can do stuff that dreams can't, like put food on the table.
What's this?
I thought you might be hungry when you came home from work, so I made it myself at the deli.
I never tasted better.
Good. Let me know when you find my finger.